social contagion theory explains how our moods, our habits, and our behaviours travel across social networks for as far as 3 degrees of separation. The things we do will have an impact on people we may never even meet. In this way, we are all connected. So when we invest in our mental health, it doesn't just benefit us, our family, and our friends. It also benefits the wider society and the wider world we live in. We all hold a lot of power.
So for example, if you were to smile and hold the door open for somebody, that wouldn't just have an impact on that person, it would also have an impact on someone that they came into contact with, and then someone that that person came into contact with. So person A is having an impact on person D, even though they might never meet.
Mental health is not just a clinical condition, it's resilience. It's the ability to enjoy life and survive pain. It's a belief in the worth of others and ourselves. It exists on a continuum on which we are all placed and applies to us all. A recent report by the Centre for Mental Health showed that £23.1 billion a year is lost in productivity due to mental health problems alone.
In mental health, as in sports, even the best must practice daily.
I have my goals board in my bedroom, so every time I wake up, I see it. And it encourages me to continue through my day to reach my goal. So it doesn't seem that impossible and that far away.
I liked the humour and playfulness one, because it just kind of, I need reminding that it's okay to, you know, be silly and have a laugh, and that actually that's not a waste of time. In the past I've kind of felt like I can only be creative if it serves a purpose, where actually it is serving a purpose, it's helping me to be myself and, you know, to enjoy life. For me, the important thing is that coming here has given me permission. You know, it's, you know, there's all the research and everything else, you know, there's a good reason to spend time doing things I enjoy. It's not a waste of time to have fun.